Success! These are my friends Olivia and Connor. Can we get a whoop whoop? Yeah, so we've just emptied all the seats out of the bus. This is my first time seeing it this empty, and I absolutely love it. Norm and Karen, just on the back end with their trailer. They're going to trailer the seats out of here, help keep out the landfill. And yeah, just generally a really successful weekend. So thanks everybody. I am absolutely floored. No, really, I've got work to do on the floor today. I need to finish prepping the floor so that I can rust proof it. So I need to do a rust proof paint and a weather barrier, like air vapor barrier. So I've got lots of screw heads that I need to hammer out and grind out. And I've also got to do some, I've got wire brushes that I need to use to, to get rid of some of this rust. Here. It's only surface rust, it's nothing to be concerned about, but I need to get it back down to bare metal so that then when I paint it, it's in the best condition it can be. So, kind of without further ado.
Yo. I go by the name of Pharrell from the Neptunes, and I just want to let y'all know.
So basically what I'm doing is I'm having to hammer out all of the screws that are stuck in the frame, and right now I'm over my 200 plus litre diesel tank, and there's something counterintuitive about hammering screws down into where you know your diesel tank is, but yeah, I know my diesel tank is dropped low enough for it not to be an issue, but it's still kind of a funny feeling. Only big boys keep deuces on a ride. Gucci Chuck Taylor with the dragon on the side. Man, I make a buck while I scram. I'm trying to show y'all who the fuck I am. The Jews is flirting, be damned if I'm hurting. Legend in two games like I'm Pee Wee Kirkland. Platinum on the block with consistent hits. While Pharrell keep talking this music.
Baker's man, I bake them cakes as fast as I can, and you can tell by how my bread stack up, then disguise it as rap so the feds back up. Watch it, like my whip, like my chick topless, doing a buck six with me in the cockpit, grinding cousin, I got four dozen, even 11.5 if I see you keep it coming. In my weight, that's just as heavy as my name, so much dough I can't swear I won't change. Excuse me if my wealth got me full of myself, cocky, something that I just can't help. Especially when them 20s is spinning like windmills, and the ice 32 below minus the wind chill. Filthy, the word that best defines me. I'm just grinding, man. Y'all never mind me.
So, I have another load of timber from my friend's construction site. So, I figure, I must have about $500 worth of free wood at the moment. There's a lumber shortage. They had to shut down all the mills because of COVID. So, there's a lumber shortage, there's a housing boom, and I've just picked up $500 worth of free wood that would have been thrown away. The world is crazy. Hello and welcome back to the Share Happiness Bus, welcome back to the Beer Bus, welcome back to Busta Rhymes, welcome back to Octobus Prime. I still need a name for it, so if you have any thoughts or suggestions, please comment below. Today is a pretty pivotal day. I need to decide on insulation today. I looked at a few ways to insulate the bus, spray foam being kind of the first way. Spray foam quotes were between $2,500 and $3,500, which is way out of my price range at the moment, so that is not an option. You can get like spray kits that you do yourself, but they are notoriously difficult and finicky and tricky, and those again would be about $1,000 to $1,500 plus. I am insulating with foam boards. I've got some foam boards here, and I'll talk about those again in just a bit. I'm moving into this bus for the winter on a mountain. In Canada, in the winter, temperatures can be as low as minus 25 or minus 30 in January. They generally will be about minus 10 to 15 for the winter. So I need to insulate this bus really, really, really well. For heating, I have a 30,000 BTU propane furnace. I have a 15,000 BTU diesel furnace. And I also am keeping the original underseat bus heaters just as kind of backup emergency heaters, just in case. But there's no point in heating your bus if it's not insulated and you can't keep the heat in. So that's what I'm kind of planning today. I have found a company locally that makes insulated food delivery trucks, you know, that deliver groceries, ice cream, seafood, frozen foods, basically. And so they have thousands of panels off this foam insulation board. It's similar to the stuff that you'll find at like building supply stores, but it's different. Similar but different. Per 4x8 foot sheet from the renovation store, this stuff will cost you maybe $60, $70, $80 a sheet. This stuff is only about $2, $3, $4 a sheet, depending on how much you buy. Now it's only half an inch thick, so I need to layer them, either 4 or 6 sheets to get kind of a 4-inch or a 6-inch thick insulation barrier. So it's going to cost me a lot in terms of time and energy and effort to cut the panels, to shape them, to layer them, to tape them, to stagger them, etc., etc. But I'm saving money kind of on the front end. Again, I'm probably going to need about 400 to 500 for these panels. I've kind of calculated floor space being about 250 square feet, the roof being about 250 square feet, each wall being about 200 square feet plus the front and end of the bus. I've kind of rounded that out to about 1,000 square feet, and so in order to insulate it, I'm going to need about 400 to 500 of these panels. Hopefully that's overkill, but we'll see. Most houses in Canada are insulated to an R value of about R20 to R60, and the R value basically is the efficiency of your insulation. Most houses in Canada have an R rating of 40 to 60 because of the cold winter climates in Canada. I'm going to aim for an R rating of about R20 for most of this bus and about R30 to 40 in the back section. So I'm doing this in two kind of sets. The front half of the bus will be insulated to about R20. The front two-thirds of the bus will be insulated to about R20. And then where my bed is going to be, that is going to have additional insulation. So I can just, on the very cold nights, I can section off my bed and just heat my bedroom area and kind of maybe be a bit more efficient, but also stay warm. So, long story short, these are some insulation panels which I bought the other day just to test fit, measure, cut, etc. Half an inch thick, so they're quite flexible. They do bend and contour, you know, to the curves and the shape of the bus. But I am going to have to layer them. I'm going to have to cut them, layer them, stagger them, tape them. There's going to be a lot of work on the back end, but I need to do all my measurements and all my calculations today so that I can place my order and pick up the insulation for next week. Now, there's snow in the forecast. Like, in 2 or 3 days. The snow will probably melt within a couple of days, but the first snowfall of the season is on its way, so it is basically crunch time for me. I think I've got 22 days before I have to move into the bus. I'm on schedule, but I am under a time crunch. Anyway, I will try and keep you posted. Thank you for your interest, and we'll speak to you soon.